Todos me dicen el negro llorona, negro, pero cariñoso. Todos me dicen el negro llorona, negro, pero cariñoso.
Grandpa's father was Apache. His mother died giving birth to him. He was raised by the Montanos of Chimayo, New Mexico, and became Jacobo Montano. Jacobo came to Salt Lake as a young man, met Grandma Genara, and became her second husband. No llores, abuelo. Those were the words my mother taught me to say. Don't cry, Grandpa. We visited him every Sunday. Photographs covered every bit of wall space in his room. Mom as a baby, Mom as a pachuca, Mom with all six of his kids squeezing together. And then those ridiculous school-grade pictures. A homemade haircut, the suspenders and baggy clothes that distinguish us from every other kid in the neighborhood. These photos carried our stories, documented our lives. No llores, we said to him as he hung his head low, trying to cover his tears. He spoke to us in Spanish. After his last stroke, he couldn't remember how to speak English. We looked at him blankly, confused, not understanding. No llores, abuelo, I said as he stroked my hair, my long, dark hair that he loved so much. I didn't cry at his funeral, and then he was gone. 10 years later, my hair cut short above my ears, the memory of those Sunday afternoon visits lay buried by years of accumulated dust, until that terrible day. My sister called crying uncontrollably. My 3-year-old nephew, the child I nursed as a baby, had been brutally beaten, had 24 hours to live. No brain activity, the doctor said. No llores, the words came rushing over the years. No llores, a budding life yanked out by its root. What was happening to my family? We were losing our language and now even our lives. How had the love for my grandfather, the smell of chiles fresh from his garden, the story of my family transformed into a tragedy on the 10 o'clock news? How had the agony and desperation come to occupy the space where my grandfather and my ancestors once lived? No llores. I remember the touch of his hand caressing my hair. I stared at my nephew's dying body, tubes and machines struggling to keep his tender heart alive. In and out, wandering the hallways. Wake up. Wake up. The next day, my sisters held baby Orlando, saying their last goodbyes. I reached again for Grandpa, seeking the warmth of his room and the photos that filled his walls. I saw our lives the way they once were. There, with Grandpa Jacobo in his room, we existed. No llores. His words struggled to find meaning for his grandchildren. We struggled to understand. Grandpa cried for us, not for himself. His journey was over. But he knew we were alone. Who would tell us, his grandchildren, that we were beautiful and strong, that we exist? Oh, llores. I wiped my own tears away that day. On that terrible day of my nephew's death, I remember Grandpa Jacobo's tears, the feeling of his hands on my hair. I was reminded of the dignity of our lives. I was able to say goodbye to my nephew and walk out of that hospital because I had a journey ahead of me. I was going to gather those photos, dust them off, and place them in front of everyone the way they were shown to me during those beautiful days in Grandpa's room. I was going to tell our stories. I was not going to forget again. No llores, abuelo. I understand what you are trying to tell me.
Todos me dicen el negro llorona, negro, pero cariñoso. Todos me dicen el negro llorona, negro, pero cariñoso. Yo soy como el chile verde llorona, picante, pero sabroso. Yo soy como el chile verde llorona, picante, pero sabroso. Ay, de mi llorona, 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 llévame al río. Tápame con tu rebozo, llorona, porque me muero de frío. Sí, porque te quiero, quieres, llorona, quieres que te quiera más. Si ya te da